Hello everyone. I hope you all are following the rules of lockdown. We also wish for your safety, and that's why we are coming this way in front of you. We will try to discuss all the topics in very short period of time so that it will be easy for you to understand and it will be easy for you to make all things clear to you. Then today the topic that I'm going to discuss with you is the cell and cell organelles. Now, what a cell is? Cell is the structural and functional unit of any living being. Means cell is responsible for making the structure and is responsible for performing any function in any living being. So cell is like the brick of home. Like a home is made up of many bricks, in the same way the body is made up of cells. Okay, so cell is the structural as well as functional unit of any living being. Cell is the structural and functional unit of animals and plants also, because we both are the living beings. So now we will discuss which type of cell organelles are present in a cell. First of all, it is the nucleus. Then these are the lysosomes. This is the mitochondria. This is the Golgi body. This is the ribosome. This is the cell vacuole. And in plant cells, it is the chloroplast. And this is the cell membrane. Another boundary is present in plant cells, that is called cell wall. So in plant cells and animal cells, there is a basic difference that in plant cell, two outer boundaries are present. One is cell wall and another is cell membrane. But in animal cell, only cell membrane is present. The second main difference is in the animal cell, plastids, means chloroplast, leucoplast and chromoplast, are not present. But plastids are present only in plant cells. These are the main differences. And third main difference is the size of vacuole. In plant cell, vacuole is very large in size, and in animal cell there are very small vacuoles. These are some main differences in the plant and animal cell. Now I would like to start the cell organelles in detail. The first cell organelle is nucleus. Now what the nucleus structure comprises of? Nucleus has a membrane. This membrane is called nuclear membrane. What the membrane is called? Nuclear membrane. And this membrane has some pores in it. There are some pores in the nuclear membrane so that all the things can pass through it. Then these pores come in the limelight. So these pores are called nuclear pores. The nucleus has a circular structure that is called nucleolus. It is called nucleolus. Then the liquid filled in the nucleus is called nucleoplasm. What is it called? Nucleoplasm. And the last and most important thing is the genetic material filled in the nucleus. It is the genetic material which is responsible for heredity. So it is the, and the genetic material is present in the nucleus. That is why nucleus is called the control center of the cell. Now what do you mean by control center? Control center means the thing that is responsible for the regulation of all the activities like cell growth, cell division, metabolism. All these are controlled by the control center of cell, and this is the nucleus. So that's it for